रियो का प्रो
मैनेज Long time ago, we assembled in this very place, and those were the days of emergency. Not that emergency was a surprise, but Mrs. Gandhi was on a wrong track. She wanted committed journalists, committed judiciary, committed bureaucracy. This time, we are reminded of the same thing. Again, we want commitment to their ideology, and those who don't fall in line, they will meet the fate of NDTV, and this is a warning sign. During emergency, there was a meeting here organized by none else than Mr. Kuldeep Nair. I was one of them. People turned up, and next stage was Mr. Kuldeep Nair was in the jail. It can happen again. Emergency, during emergency, the record of the press was not very noble, what it ought to have been, excepting for the Indian Express, the Statesman, Economic and Political Weekly, and A.D. Gorewala's Opinion, little magazine. They stood up, but the rest of the press, by and large, there can be exception in the regional press, was not that noble that it ought to be. They crawled, actually, as Advani said. Then came the defamation bill. By this time, the press was very conscious. Here was a bill, defamation bill, brought forward to stop exposures. You all know what it was about, the Bofors. They could pass in the Lok Sabha without notice. 3.5 hours it took the bill to be passed, and the next day they were to offload into the Rajya Sabha. Entire press united. Many of us went on front page, other efforts were made, debates were there, all the organizations of the newspaper across the country joined in, it became a national movement. Rajiv Gandhi at that time offered talks. Talks were refused. We had meetings, we used to meet on Ferozshah Road, said no talk, nobody to talk to Rajiv Gandhi, it was a mellified measure and it has to be withdrawn unilaterally. The fact is the unity of journalists, which had the backing of the people behind it, born out of the emergency failure, won the battle. They had to withdraw the bill. The government of 402 seats in parliamentary, later on became 413, had to withdraw the bill because the people were against. Similar signs are visible now. Here also, there has to be nationalistic press, nationalistic judiciary, nationalistic bureaucracy, everything. Now the signs are similar, so unless we do something right now, unless we are united, unless we are aware of the dangers, we can meet the same fate. What one of the most distorted actors is a dispute between a bank and a client. There are ways to sort it out. You are letting Vijay Malaya go, you are letting Lalit Modi escape on one-way ticket, not a two-way ticket either. Neither Vijay Malaya has bought the two-way ticket, nor Lalit Modi has bought the two-way ticket. And you are hauling one of the roast, hauling up one of the, raiding the house of one of the most respected journalists of the country. If this is not an attack on the freedom of the press, what could have been sorted by the bank and the client? The press has to pay the price for it. This is the result. This is not meant only for NDTV, let's face facts. This is a warning to all others that if you don't fall in line, you will meet a similar fate. Without realizing, you are sowing the seeds of dissent, getting more encouragement. It's a wake-up call. And people are waking up more as what's happening in that many parts of the country. The dissent is leading to anger, and anger is leading to many other things. So this is a wake-up call. I think we should be cautious and vigilant about further attacks. And this should be undone, this kind of things, which is CBI being used to curb the freedom of the press. There can't be anything worse. Thank you very much.